Welcome into our Thursday edition of Daily Island Football Forum. I'm Rob Miller alongside Brendan Stiles down here in Miami, Florida. Beautiful, about 75 degrees, just a few clouds in the sky. Everybody's wearing t-shirts and shorts, not to make you too jealous or anything. Today or Wednesday, we got our first look at an Iowa football practice. The team was in full pad, or not full pads.
They were in shorts.
Shoulder pads and yeah. And helmets, and they were hitting a little bit, getting a good look of the Georgia Tech offense and Georgia Tech defense on the scout team. What were some of your observations from today's practice?
Well, I made two major observations with practice on Wednesday. The first being that Trace Joss wasn't in uniform when the team was doing warm-ups. He was warming up with the team, but he was not dressed out in shoulder pads and helmet, and he was not taking part in any wide receiver drills. When asking Coach Ferentz about it on Wednesday, though, he just said it was kind of a limited thing and that it wasn't going to be a big deal. The other big observation I noticed, and I know you picked up on it as well, is the shifting along the offensive line. Noticing Kyle Callaway, who's been at right tackle every game of the season except for the first one that he was suspended.
Sliding over
a little right guard, having Riley Reif over at right tackle, and then Julian Vandervelde at left guard. So, I mean, that to me, the players made it sound like it was a precaution, but and that it's just something that they do all the time, but I don't know. I thought it was kind of interesting that they had that going while we were there.
Yeah, and Coach Ferentz touched on that as well, saying that that's something they do on a regular basis. But it'll be interesting to see if Reef has been slid over to the right tackle position to help on Derek Morgan, the stud defensive end for Georgia Tech. A few other observations. A few guys out running around, Jewel Hampton and Jordan Bernstein and Jeff Brinson all getting a few runs in there, so it's good to see those guys healthy.
The other thing, while we're talking about the offensive line here, Dace Richardson, he wasn't taking part with the first team, but he was dressed. He was taking part in drills, even though it was with the second unit. They're so optimistic that he'll be able to play on Tuesday against Georgia Tech. It'll be interesting to see if he can and what type of impact he'll have on the offensive line.
Yep, so from beautiful Miami, Florida, your Thursday edition of Daily Island Football Forum. I'm Rob Miller. He's Brendan Stiles. We'll be back with you again tomorrow.